The real dangers and effects of blue light from cell phones, computers, and LED bulbs. Nowadays, blue light is becoming more of a health concern because of the chronic use of screens and LED bulbs. But what is it? Well, blue light is part of the visible light spectrum, which usually comes from the sun along with all of the other colours which you can see. The problem is that blue light is now also emitted from mobile devices, computers, TVs, fluorescent bulbs and LED bulbs, which we're all now using all of the time around the home and office. Here you can see an image of your eye. The light travels through the front part of the eye, called the cornea, through the lens, and travels to the back, which is called the retina. This is where the different cells called rods and cones pick up light, so that you can see different colours. Unfortunately, studies are now showing us that being exposed to too much of this blue-violet light in the spectrum between 415 and 455 nanometers can be incredibly damaging to your eyes and also to different parts of your brain. In this video, we're going to be exploring the dangers of blue-violet light and how it affects your hormones, your eyesight, and your overall health. Afterwards, we'll also take a look at some simple ways to protect yourself against these harmful light rays in the modern world. Just a quick reminder, this video is for educational purposes only, so do speak to your doctor if you have any medical concerns. One of the main concerns with blue-violet light is how it can damage your eyes in various ways. Firstly, studies are showing us that too much blue-violet light can cause inflammation and oxidative damage to the front part of your eye called the cornea. This causes the eye to produce less tears, leaving them unlubricated, feeling dry, irritated, and with a gritty sensation. The lack of tears also makes your eyes more vulnerable to infections from viruses and bacteria, which is something that I've personally suffered with after working in an office for 8 hours a day. Number 2, cataracts. Another problem with staring at screens and phones all of the time is that it can also lead to the formation of cataracts, which appear as a white film across the lens of your eye. This also happens to people who are exposed to too much sunlight because the lens of the eye changes colour in order to help protect the retina at the back of the eye as a protective mechanism. Fortunately, there are certain nutrients called lutein and zeaxanthin which can help to protect and reverse this type of damage, but we'll talk more about these later in the video. The third danger is that it ruins your eyesight. One of the most important parts of your eye is the retina, at the back of the eye as I just mentioned. This is where light is converted into electrical signals that are sent to your brain so that you can see images and in colour. The problem with artificial blue-purple light is that it's been shown to penetrate the retina and cause photochemical damage. It also leads to swelling, fluid retention, and calcification of the eye that can cause blurred vision and difficulty focusing on objects. Over time, the blue light and also the eye strain from staring at flickering screens causes the ciliary muscles in your eyes to become very tense, causing poor eyesight and the need for prescription glasses, and also a higher risk of macular degeneration with age. If you're finding this information helpful at all, please hit the like button, subscribe, and turn all notifications on to stay updated with my latest health and nutrition tips. Moving away from your eyes now and onto your brain, let's take a look at number 4, ruin sleep. Our bodies have a hormonal wave-like pattern called the circadian rhythm, or the body clock. This causes us to sleep at night and wake up in the morning in a regular pattern. Natural blue light from the sun helps to turn off the sleep hormone called melatonin in the morning so that you can wake up and feel refreshed. Normally, as the sun goes down, naturally melatonin levels in the brain start to go up to make you feel sleepy and to fall asleep at night. The problem with this is that artificial blue light from devices interrupts this natural pattern. In fact, studies show that blue light can suppress melatonin by up to 5 times more than the sun. So if you're looking at your phone, TV, or devices at nighttime, you're far less likely to get a deep restorative night's sleep, and you'll be much more likely to wake up at irregular times, which over time can cause some severe damage to your overall health. If you do suffer from sleeping difficulties, you may want to switch off all of your devices 1 to 2 hours before bed to support your pineal gland in releasing melatonin so that you can get sleepy. Danger number 5 is that it also raises cortisol. In addition to lowering melatonin, excessive blue light exposure has also been shown to raise cortisol and adrenaline. These are the stress hormones. Emotional stress can also raise cortisol. So if you combine the anxieties of life with the uses of screens every night, the lack of sleep, and the eye strain, you get this cocktail of cortisol-boosting effects, which has a devastating effect on your overall health. High levels of cortisol over a prolonged period of time keeps your body in a state called the fight or flight, where your nervous system becomes overactive. High cortisol causes muscle loss, especially in the lower legs. It causes higher blood sugars, which are converted into body fat, especially in the liver and around the belly area. This then raises your blood pressure, increases the risk of heart disease, diabetes, anxiety, depression, and a range of other health problems. If you'd like to find out yourself if you have high cortisol, check out my video entitled 8 Signs You Have High Cortisol, which I'll put a link to in the video description. Now that we've explored some of the potential dangers of blue-violet light exposure, let's take a look at 5 practical things that you can do to protect and restore your eyes against blue light damage. 1. 1 to 2 hours before you plan on going to sleep, dim the lights in your home and put away your phone and the devices to give your pineal gland the signal that it's time to release melatonin. Darkening your environment will help to balance out your circadian rhythm to help you sleep deeply at night, refreshing your eyes and normalizing cortisol. Also, if you'd like to take it to the next level, you can purchase these sleep lights, which emit a red light that actually stimulates the release of melatonin for better sleep. Number 2, use non-prescription blue light blocking glasses to help filter out some parts of the spectrum when you're working indoors or at home using screens. You can also purchase blue light filter covers for your phone, TV, and PC monitors to help protect your cornea, lenses, and retinas. 3. Use a blue light blocking app in your phone or software on your PC so that the LED bulbs in your screens emit less light in the blue-violet spectrum. 4. Consume foods that are rich in carotenoids regularly to support the rod and the cone cells in the retina by lowering inflammation caused by harmful blue-violet light. Carrots, Swiss chard, collard greens, kale, romaine lettuce, peppers, and shrimp are all excellent choices. Eating these regularly supplies lutein, zeaxanthin, and beta-carotene, all of which help you to see better in the dark and reduce photochemical damage from all types of light. 5. Avoid going on a low-fat diet and eat foods that are rich in retinol, the active form of vitamin A. This protects the 1.7 million nerve fibers of the eye and helps to keep them lubricated. The best sources of retinol are grass-fed beef liver, virgin cod liver oil, pasture-raised egg yolks, real butter, not margarine or shortening, European cheeses, and mackerel. And 6. To reset your circadian rhythm, melatonin, and cortisol cycles, try to wake up early when the sun is rising, go outside, and expose yourself to full-spectrum light for 20 to 30 minutes. Take a walk and stare at distant objects to relax the muscles of the eye and breathe in lots of fresh air, as this can reduce cortisol. Finally, I'd like to share with you some of the best nutritional supplements that you can take to support healthy eyes and protect against blue light damage. Firstly, you can take a supplement which contains 25 mg of lutein and 5 mg of zeaxanthin on a daily basis. These are directly absorbed into the lenses of your eyes, helping to absorb and filter out blue-violet light, whilst also protecting against oxidative damage. You can also consider taking 1-2 teaspoons of virgin cod liver oil on a daily basis, as this will supply your eyes with lots of active vitamin A called retinol, along with essential omega-3 fats. These nutrients support the structure and the function of the eye, especially the nerve tissue, helping you to see better in low light and have less eye strain. Another powerful fish oil supplement is called Arctic krill oil, which contains an extremely powerful carotenoid called astaxanthin. This helps to prevent cell death in the eyes caused by blue light and LED light exposure. You can take 1 to 2,000 milligrams of this per day in a gel capsule. And finally, if you have any type of digestive damage and you have bloating, gas, acid reflux, indigestion, or inflammation in your colon, you may struggle to absorb the nutrients that I just shared with you, such as the vitamin A, omega-3s, and carotenoids. To boost your absorption, take 1 to 2 capsules of digestive enzymes, which also contain ox bile, before each meal of the day. These directly support your gut-brain connection to deliver the nutrients to your brain and eyes for better overall health. Following a healthy diet and eating the right foods can make a massive impact on brain and eye health. So if you'd like to go a little deeper and learn more about the healthiest foods for your eyes, go ahead and tap on this video on the screen now. Thank you so much for watching this video today, and as always, I wish you great health, wealth, and happiness.